And let's dig into this now with our expert. Rich is with us, along with Allison Holcomb from Washington State's ACLU. Pierre Thomas back as well. And Ricardo Baca, the marijuana editor of the Denver Post. No major paper's ever had that post before. Welcome.
Thank you.
To you as well. And Rich, let me start out with you, because you surprised me a little bit here. You said you started out skeptical in the arguments for legalization, but have kind of evolved.
Yeah, you know, I'm a parent of two teenage boys. I'm a pediatrician. And I'm very concerned about the impact on the developing brain from frequent use. And so I went into the story thinking there's no way this should be legal. But the more I got into the story, the more I was convinced by the arguments around the comparison between alcohol and its dangers and marijuana. And it's just not rational that adults don't have the choice of using marijuana, but they do for alcohol. Marijuana is less likely to be addictive. It's less likely to cause car accidents and birth defects. It's less likely to cause domestic violence. So how do you rationally say that it's okay to drink alcohol with that profile, but it's not okay to occasionally use marijuana?
How do you do that, Pierre?
Well, it's interesting. I spent some time doing some research, talking to law enforcement officials, and one of the things they point out is that this is not your daddy's marijuana, that the marijuana today is three times more powerful if you look at the THC, which is the active ingredient. And they're very concerned about the effect on younger people. So that's one of the things they're concerned about. And also they say that you have to look at how is the legal system going to adjust to accommodate this. You saw with the state trooper, there's no way to test for it really on the highway.
And I want to bring that to Ricardo now, because you're on the ground with this beat, this marijuana beat in Colorado, and it is unprecedented. I have to ask you the first question you probably always get. So do you use it?
I do, yeah. I use it both medically and recreationally.
Okay, and then what are you seeing on the ground? I was most struck by one of your observations. You actually can smell the difference in Denver and Boulder?
You can. If you went back a couple years in the metro area and took a big whiff in downtown Denver, downtown Boulder, you know, it would have been your average city. But now I think if you're at a Bronco game, if you're out in downtown Denver, you can actually smell the difference. We were at the Justin Timberlake concert just a few weeks ago, and you could definitely smell the difference there. And it's, of course, it's been ever present at concerts for decades.
What's the biggest challenge so far?
The biggest challenge, you know, it comes down to keeping it out of kids' hands, but also keeping it from crossing state lines. When that Justice Department memo came out saying, Colorado, Washington, go for it, but we're watching you, you know, it's just like we have to pay attention to those bits and pieces that are very important.
You're part of the campaign in Washington State to have it legalized. And this is, you know, the sort of the forefront of efforts. We're starting to see efforts in other states as well.
Right. We are. We're seeing Oregon, Alaska, California is looking at it. They don't know when they're going with it. I think what you're seeing nationwide is that the conversation has changed from, does it make sense for us to continue treating this like a criminal matter, to how can we do this in a responsible way where we're not only focusing on keeping it out of the kids' hands, but maybe we're also providing kids some proactive information to help them make better choices for themselves.
And you know, we were with the president this week. He made the powerful argument. He tried to clarify his arguments where he said, listen, it's just not fair that if you're a young African-American kid, you're going to get a far harsher sentence than someone else. But then doesn't that potentially lead to the argument is why not just stop at decriminalization? Why go all the way towards legalization?
I think the concern with stopping with decriminalization is that we do have to address the black market. If we don't address the black market, kids are going to keep getting marijuana that's three times as strong as THC. That's happening outside of any sort of regulatory structure. We need the regulations, we need licensing, we need standards.
And then the other counterargument to the argument you were making, Rich Besser, is, pot may be no worse than alcohol, but once you get a whole lot of money marketing behind it, it's going to be impossible. We've seen it with cigarettes. We've seen it with alcohol. The kids are going to start using it earlier and earlier and potentially get hooked.
Yeah, and, you know, I think that that is one area. There has to be a lot of focus on regulation. And we also have to look really closely at what happens in Colorado and Washington State and learn from that experience. I do worry about kids using this, and we have to be clear in this that it's not a signal saying it's okay for kids to smoke pot. But I know in the community we live in, kids are smoking pot without this. And hopefully bringing it away from the black market and bringing it out in the open, we're able to get those messages through in a better way.
Is that signal being sent in Colorado? Do you feel that?
It's definitely being sent. I mean, and Rich makes a good point. I mean, this is in middle schools. This is in high schools. It's everywhere. But the education process is very serious. I know the state has been making inroads in actually high schools and going out and having conversations. And we take our job responsibly in terms of educating the public too. This is a strong product. You know, start with.
So you write about that.
I do. Oh yeah, yeah. We've written multiple times about just the sheer strength of it and good amounts. It's good to start if you're new with 5 milligrams of an edible. It's a very solid way of measuring the amount of pot that you're about to ingest.
George, one of the things that struck me about this whole thing is when you start to look at the marijuana, Americans have had a love affair with marijuana. If you look at the black market, they're trucking it into the country by the hundreds of tons. I went to a private location, secret location, where the government disposes of the illegal. They're disposing of it by forklift. It's just incredible to see.
And it's going to be really hard, Rich Besser, to keep it out of the hands of kids.
I think it is. I mean, right now, it's hard to keep alcohol out of the hands of kids. It's hard to keep marijuana out of the hands of kids. And we need to do a better job around that. And I think a lot of that comes down to parenting. Education in school is one thing, but it comes down to what are you saying at home and what examples are you setting. But this doesn't change that. The fact that it's illegal now, kids are using this. It's rampant. Saying it's legal for adults to use that is I think, a rational approach.
That is all we have time for. I wish we had more time. I want you all to come back at some point. Thank you all very much.